What about talking about advanced interior projects? Let's dive in into the topic. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel, we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will give you some tips on how to create the interior shots on the advanced level. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you won't miss any future tutorials. So there was a time in my professional life that I could say that my interior visualizations were okay, but they weren't too great yet. They simply lack of something. And over the years, I have learned some important lessons that help me to improve my interior visualizations. And what is more, they have become my favorite type of RVs images. So let me share with you some important things I have learned back then based on the examples. Using high-quality models is important in every kind of visualizations, including exteriors and interiors. However, in the interior shots, it's crucial to use high-quality, well-modeled 3D models in the foreground and in the detail shots. Look at this image as an example. High-quality models of sofas, armchairs, coffee tables, pendant lamps, bar counter, bar stools, etc., as well as accessories like flowers or pillows, help in creating photorealistic images. The quality of the models is what makes or breaks your image, so it's worth spending time on modeling or selecting high-quality models from the online shops. Another thing we should consider when creating the interior image is using advanced, high-quality materials. The most important thing here is to use high-resolution textures with lots of details and using different types of maps. For example, diffuse maps, reflection, normal, and displacement maps, and so on. For example, let's look at this velvet material. Not only the high-quality maps were used, for instance, we added the sheen layer that in general makes fabrics look like fabrics with a different look at greasing angles. Talking about the materials, it's important to mention using surface imperfection maps. There is nothing like this, which adds so much detail and realism to the image, especially if we are talking about the close-up shots like this one. For instance, all these small scratches add lots of realism to the image. As you probably know, nothing in real life is perfect and all objects have some small defects. This is why it's so important to add these small details to your images, as we obviously want to imitate reality. Storytelling is something that I talk a lot about on this channel. And I couldn't miss this point here as well. Stories can be open or closed depending on the effect we want to achieve. In this example, we decided on the open story that gives the viewer room for interpretation. We wanted to engage our viewers, allow them to read this space differently depending on their experiences, past emotions, and so on. Of course, we created the background for this story. We guide the viewers in the way through the story, but we don't show everything directly. Thanks to this, we add life and character to the image. We create a specific mood and atmosphere that gives the viewer an idea of what he or she can expect, but it doesn't define the story too specifically. The good news is that the images I've just shown you are the part of our brand new advanced interior training. So you can learn how to create them step by step with us. I can promise there will be lots of knowledge and basically everything you need to know to create images like this. We included the modeling module where we will show you how to model the main scene. Besides, we'll walk you through the idea behind the images that helps you understand the decision we make during the production process. We'll create a bunch of nice materials together. we'll show you our approach to setting up the lighting and using the post-production process. Basically, you'll learn our way of approaching projects like this one. There will be more than 60 lessons. Important news is that we include the book, The Art of RVs Images, as a bonus for free for orders that will be placed in the next couple of days. Definitely check it out if you want to create images like this. I will put the link to the course in the corner and in the description below. Okay, with that being said, let's move to the next point. Talking about storytelling, we cannot miss lighting that plays a huge role in creating mood and atmosphere in the space. It is an awesome tool that can help you showing the space in a specific way. For example, in this project, we wanted to create an impression of the high-end image. For this reason, we used dark lighting to make our space appear more mysterious and moody. Additionally, we chose to create the high contrast image as it attracts attention, creates a more dramatic look. As our goal was to catch the attention straight away, this was one of the best methods to do so. When we are talking about any type of image, the composition is a key. However, when we want to experiment and create something more advanced, trying unexpected cameras can be one of the solutions. A great example can be this shot, where we have the camera that is higher than we typically do in interiors, plus it is positioned behind the pendant lights, which creates a nice framing effect. Additionally, in this image we created the depth of field effect that helps in framing and differentiating the foreground and the background. Another thing that can help in showing the interior space is creating a set of images instead of only one image that shows everything or almost everything in the space. What I mean by this is to, for example, create a couple of main images that show the context of the space, but also some details and perspectives that enhance the atmosphere, feel, and design of the place. In the bar details, for example, we presented elegant materials, attention to the execution of the details. In the canvas opening image, we showed the details of the design that influence the atmosphere in the space. So all of these things help me to improve my interior visualizations and be proud of the work I've created. And I hope they will help you as well and make you fall in love in this type of image. Remember, in general, it's all about paying attention to small details. By the way, if the advanced interior training sounds interesting for you and you would like to learn how to create all the images I've just shown you, don't forget to take a closer look. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye bye!